So 10 man, Miranda Lambert, who used to come see me play when she was a 15-year-old girl with her mom, just driving. She would come see me in the dumpest of dumps, and she'd open for me sometimes, like in knack of nowhere, at like little festivals. That's how I met her. Her and her dad were playing. I was friends with her for a long time before she was Miranda Lambert. She was just this really cool chick who sometimes opened shows and had a great taste in music, and I just thought she had something special. It turns out I was right, because she was right. She did. So anyway, when she became Miranda Lambert, we stayed friends. And a couple years ago, she's like, hey, I need a break. Let's go somewhere and write. And so Jon Randall and I and Miranda went to Marfa, and we stayed at Liz Lambert's ranch house there. We stayed at her place, and we just hung out for 3 or 4 days. And while we were there, it was a trip, because Jon Randall said, turn out all the lights. Go. There was a light on the front porch. It was the only light in the house. And we had to actually go odd man out to see who was going to turn out the light. And Miranda lost, so she had to go turn out the light. And she came back, and you couldn't see anything, man. Like, you could not see a thing. You know, like, when you turn out the lights at your house, and for like 6.3 seconds, you can't see anything, you kind of freak out, like, oh my God, I'm never gonna see again. Well, down there, when you turn out the lights, it's a couple minutes, man. You cannot see in front of your face. And then we just stared there for a minute, and then all of a sudden, the stars started like popping out, like little heartbeats. And we started talking, because it's dead silent. And we started going, hey man, it's funny how like people tell us to follow our heart, follow these stars, follow this thing that we're following. But they don't really tell you how hard it's gonna be. And even for Miranda, like, she was on every cover of every stupid magazine, and you know, things weren't going great in her world. And it's the same, like, things are tough all over. And so we were just kind of going, isn't it funny how, like, we're supposed to do that, and we should, and we do. But they don't tell you how hard it's going to be. And Miranda said, we should warn the Tin Man. And then 2 hours later, we did. And the best part about making music, that's what makes people do it for nothing, is that it's a lifetime of satisfaction, because the day we wrote that song, like, we also wrote 10 other songs that week that were not on any of her records and haven't won any awards, and nobody's even heard it. But I heard it, and we made it up, and it wasn't there before we got there. And there's something, like, Tin Man was as good of a song the minute we wrote it as it was after everybody said they loved it. Because that can't matter to you, because odds are, man, 99 times out of 100, nobody's gonna ever tell you that your song's great. And so when that does happen, it's fantastic. It's better than ice cream. But when it doesn't happen, it's still pretty damn good ice cream. You know what I mean?
Hey there, Mr. Tin Man. You don't know how lucky you are. Shouldn't spend your whole life wishing for something bound to fall apart. Every time you're feeling empty, better thank your lucky stars. 'Cause if you ever felt one breaking, you never want a heart. Hey there, and Mr. Tin. You don't know how lucky you are. I've been down the road that you're on. It didn't get me very far. Hey, baby, you ain't missing nothing. 'Cause love is so damn. Come on, take it from me, darling. Baby, you don't want a heart. I'm glad we talked this out. Take mine if you want it. 'Cause it's in pieces now. And by the way there, Mr. Tin Man, if you don't mind some scars, how about you give me your armor? Baby, you can have my heart. Thank you.